Hey, I'm Gavin Rossdale, and you're watching Fuse On Demand. Get it when you want it.
Lazarus is actually my middle name, and I just feel like over the past couple of years, a lot of the adversity that I've been faced with, a lot of personal stuff, you know, relationship-wise and family-wise, and just coming out on top, I just feel like it's really synonymous with, you know, the story of Lazarus in the Bible. After taking this trip with Staying Alive, this HIV and AIDS awareness campaign, I went to South Africa, the Philippines, and India, and came back a changed man for sure, you know. So coming out on top and after all that, I just feel like it's really synonymous with, you know, the story of Lazarus in the Bible. So it just felt like the perfect title. Well, gym class, as far as recording goes, is definitely a democratic process, you know what I mean? We all throw our two cents in, and I mean, it could start with a drum beat that Matt comes up with, or a guitar lick that Dasashi comes up with, or a beat that I made in Logic or something, you know what I mean? And we kind of take that and build on it. Or when we work with producers, the producers will come with like a skeletal beat, and we'll just all, you know, add our two cents and until it's, you know, where we want it. With this, working with different producers and whatnot, you know, they brought their flavor to the table, and I kind of just put my twist on it, you know what I mean, and made it trappy, you know what I'm saying?
I be playing basketball with the president, dunking on his delegates, then I compliment him on his political etiquette.
Billionaires, basically, it's kind of posing a question to the listener, like, if you were, you know, in a position and you had a billion bucks to spare, you know, would you be selfish or would you be selfless, you know what I mean? And it's basically me talking about what I'd do if I had a billion bucks, you know. And it's definitely not popping bottles and, you know, clubbing and spending ridiculous amounts of money on stuff that I'm not going to be able to take with me to the grave, you know, so. I did a song with Kesha called Want You Bad that the unmixed demo version leaked out onto the internet, and the song was awesome, I thought, but it didn't make the record, but it's out there now for public consumption, and people are loving it. Kesha's awesome, you know what I mean? I dig what she's doing. I think she's definitely, you know, in her own lane, and it's something about, you know, someone who brushes their teeth with a bottle of Jack that's kind of sexy, you know?